Hello friends, let us now learn about the necrosis. So first we will see the types of necrosis. Necrosis is death of a cell which occurs due to some stimuli. So necrosis can be divided into five major types. We have coagulative necrosis, liquefactive necrosis, caseous necrosis, fat necrosis and fibrinoid necrosis. First, let us learn about coagulative necrosis, which is the most common type of necrosis and occurs most commonly due to ischemia. Whenever there is inactivation or denaturation of hydrolytic enzymes, coagulative necrosis will occur. So, this coagulative necrosis is associated with appearance of tombstone appearance, and it occurs in all the organs of our body except the brain. The appearance of the organ remains intact. There is no loss of tissue architecture in coagulative necrosis. Zenker's degeneration is a type of coagulative necrosis in skeletal muscles, which is also associated with typhoid. It is also associated with neutrophilic infiltration, and all types of infarcts are coagulative necrosis. One important thing in coagulative necrosis is here there is no loss or damage of tissue architecture. Then the second type of necrosis which we can see is liquefactive necrosis. Liquefactive necrosis occurs in hydrolytic enzyme activation. Here there is activation of hydrolytic enzymes which will break down or damage the tissue architecture, resulting in liquefactive necrosis. There is abscess formation occurs due to liquefactive necrosis. Examples of liquefactive necrosis are, it is seen in CNS and ischemia infection, especially the pus that occurs during infection in abscess formation. That is a type of liquefactive necrosis. The third type of necrosis is caseous necrosis, which is both coagulative and liquefactive necrosis. In caseous necrosis, there is presence of cheese-like material. Even here, the structural outline is not preserved even in caseous necrosis. It is most commonly seen in tuberculosis, fungal infection, syphilis, and it is also seen in monocytic and lymphocytic infiltration. In monocytic lymphocytic infiltration, we see caseous necrosis. The fourth type of necrosis is fat necrosis. This fat necrosis occurs due to lipases, which is pancreatitis. In pancreatitis, there is lipase which is released out of the pancreas, and this will convert the lipid of omentum to fatty acid. This fatty acid combines with calcium to form saponification, which is a chalk-like yellowish white deposits which are seen. Examples of this fat necrosis is injury to omentum and breast occurs in fat necrosis. Then the final type of necrosis here is fibrinoid necrosis. So this fibrinoid necrosis, it occurs mainly in endothelial injury, results in fibrinoid necrosis. This causes immune complexes are formed. These immune complexes will damage the plasma proteins which are present in the vessel wall, and these immune complexes, that is antigen and antibody complexes, will deposit in the vessel wall, resulting in fibrinoid necrosis. This type of necrosis is seen in malignant hypertension, polyarteritis nodosa, and Ascoff's bodies. Then the last type of, it is a type of necrosis, but it is a clinical term, gangrene. Gangrene is a type of necrosis, but this is mainly clinical term used in surgery. Dry gangrene, gangrenes can be either dry or wet gangrene. Dry gangrene is a type of coagulative necrosis occurring due to ischemia. dry gangrene is a coagulative necrosis occurring due to ischemia, whereas wet gangrene is a liquefactive necrosis occurring due to ischemia and secondary infection. There is also one more type of gangrene, which is gas gangrene, which is also a type of wet gangrene occurring due to Clostridium welchi infection. So this is about the types of necrosis. Thank you for watching my lecture. Thank you.